My name is Rupert Gobbe. I'm working as a developer for GFT Italy, and in IT market I work on Task 3.1. In particular, I work in the service to issue verifiable credential and the user-centric authentication. This demo is part of the work package 3, in particular of the subsystem 3.1 relating to sensor identity and identity access management. In my demo, I will show how we can issue verifiable credentials through the verifiable credential service using the Veramo framework and how we can store these credentials in the software wallet presented in Task 3.2. I will also show the user-centric authentication part, so how it is possible to authenticate users through the OpenID Connect provider using the credentials stored in the IT Market Wallet. Here we are using the Veramo framework because it allows us to integrate with the i3 Market Wallet and therefore be independent from the Uport mobile wallet application. This demo shows how to use the Verifiable Credential Service API to issue a credential, then the Wallet API to save it, and the OIDC provider API to disclose it in the authorization code flow. The authentication is shown through a single page application in Angular, which requires a token to access a page. As it was in the Uport solution, there is a dedicated API to issue a verifiable credential. This API takes as a parameter a JSON object encoded as a URL, which is the claim we want to insert in the credential we are generating. This API will produce an HTML page, so we can render it with the browser. Compared with the solution with Uport, this page does not display a QR code because we are not longer using the Uport application. Instead, it is directly calling the wallet that runs in localhost. So the wallet asks to select the identity. Then the credential is generated by the Verifiable Credential Service and sent back to the wallet that is asking if we want to accept it. Okay, once the credential is stored, we get the ID that is the credential. They did of the credential, the last one here. Once the credential is saved in the wallet, we can use it in the login with the OpenID Connect provider. We can, as we did in Uport, we can specify it in the scope of field. Again, the OpenID Connect provider is not showing a QR code for the same reason of before, and is also it calling the wallet that ask again to select the identity, and then if we agree the disclosure of the claim we are requiring, so we agree the disclosure with us. If we are able to disclose the requested credential, the an access token and an ID token are issued. So if we have a look at the access token, you can see that inside we have a verifiable credential field that contains an array of trusted credentials. And if we have a look at this credential, we can see that it is the credential we are created before, and we are asked in the scope field in the authorization flow. So, in summary, in this demo we have seen how to generate the verifiable credential through the verifiable credential service using the Veramo technology. Then we saw how to save them in the wallet and how we can use them to authenticate users with the OpenID Connect provider using the authorization code flow. That is, thank you.